Welcome to our service of morning prayer for Sunday, the 17th of October. Among the poor, among the proud, among the persecuted, among the privileged, Christ is coming to make all things new. In the private house, in the public place, in the wedding feast, in the judgment hall, Christ is coming to make all things new. With a gentle touch, with an angry word, with a clear conscience, with burning love, Christ is coming to make all things new. That the kingdom might come, that the world might believe, that the powerful might stumble, that the hidden might be seen, Christ is coming to make all things new. Within us, without us, behind us, before us, in this place, in every place, for this time, for all time, Christ is coming to make all things new.
Broken like the first morning, blackbird has spoken like the first bird. Praise for the singing, praise for the morning, praise for them springing fresh from the world. The rains new fall, sunlit from heaven, like the first dew fall on the first grass. Praise for the sweetness of the red garden, sprung in completeness where his feet. Mine is the sunlight, mine is the morning, born of the one light, Eden saw play. Praise with elation, praise every morning, God's recreation of the new day. Morning has broken like the first morning, blackbird has spoken like the first bird. Praise for the singing, praise for the morning, praise for them springing fresh from the world.
Because you made the world and intended it to be a good place, and called its people to your children, because, when things seem at their worst, you came in, Christ, to bring out the best in us. So, gracious God, we gladly say, goodness is stronger than evil, love is stronger than hate, Light is stronger than darkness. Truth is stronger than lies. Because you have promised to be near us and are able to change us and are willing to make our hearts your home, we ask you to confront, control, forgive and encourage us as you know best. Then let us cherish in our hearts that which we proclaim with our lips. Goodness is stronger than evil. Love is stronger than hate. Light is stronger than darkness. Truth is stronger than lies. Amen. Our reading is taken from Mark's Gospel, chapter 10, beginning at verse 35. James and John, the sons of Zebedee, came forward to him and said to him, "Teacher, we want you to do for us whatever we ask of you." And he said to them, "What is it that you want me to do for you?" And they said to him, "Grant us to sit one at your right hand and one at your left in your glory." But Jesus said to them, "You do not know what you are asking. Are you able to drink the cup that I drink, or be baptized with the baptism that I am baptized with?" They replied, "We are able." Then Jesus said to them, "The cup that I will drink, and with the baptism with which I am baptized, you will be baptized. But to sit at my right hand or at my left is not mine to grant, but it is for those for whom it has been prepared." When the 10 heard this, they began to be angry with James and John. So Jesus called them and said to them, "You know that among the Gentiles, those whom they recognize as their rulers lord it over them, and their great ones are tyrants over them. But it is not so among you. But whoever wishes to become great among you must be your servant, and whoever wishes to be first among you must be slave of all. For the Son of Man came not to be served, but to serve, and to give his life a ransom for many." Let us pray. Holy God, though this world depends on your grace, it is governed and tended by mortals. So we pray for those who walk the corridors of power in the parliaments of this and other lands, whose judgments we value or fear. May they always consider those they represent, make decisions with courage and integrity, and resist any temptation to abuse the trust placed in them. We pray for those who hold key positions in the worlds of finance, business, and industry, whose decisions may profit some or impoverish many. May they always value people higher than profit. May they never impose burdens on the poor which they would not carry themselves. And may they never divorce money from morality or ownership from stewardship. We pray for those in the caring professions who look after and listen to kind, cruel, and cantankerous folk, and for those who make decisions regarding the nation's health and welfare. May they always sense the sanctity of life and every person's uniqueness. May they help and heal by their interest as well as their skill, and may they be saved from tiredness and an excess of demands. And let us remember those for whom we are responsible and to whom we are accountable in what we do today. May we show to them the thoughtfulness, tolerance, and kindness of Jesus. Lord, hear our prayers, and if today we might be the means by which you answer the prayers of others, then may you find us neither deaf nor defiant, but keen to fulfil your purpose, for Jesus' sake. Amen. As our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and for ever. Amen. And a closing prayer. From where we are to where you need us, Jesus, now lead us on. From the security of what we know to the adventure of what you will reveal, Jesus, now lead us on. To refashion the fabric of this world until it resembles the shape of your kingdom, Jesus, now lead us on. Because good things have been prepared for those who love God. Jesus, now lead us on. Amen. Before people, before the world began, God was. Here and now among us, beside us, enlisting the people of earth for the purposes of heaven, God is. In the future, when we have turned to dust and all we know has found its fulfillment, God will be. Not denying the world, but delighting in it. Not condemning the world, but redeeming it through Jesus Christ by the power of the Holy Spirit. God was, God is, God will be.